I got you.
Excuse us, sorry.
No, no problem.
Here you go.
I understand that our CEOs all drove down here. Jim is a good friend of mine.
GM has been an important part of American culture for 100 years, and most of that time is the world's leading automaker. We're here today because we made mistakes, which we're learning from, because some forces beyond our control have pushed us to the brink, and most importantly, because saving General Motors and all this company represents is a job worth doing.
Mr. Chairman, Senator Shelby, we started by...
It used to be that our approach to our customers was, if you build it, they will come. We produced more vehicles than our customers wanted, and then slashed prices, hurting the residual values of those vehicles and hurting our customers. Now, we are aggressively matching production to meet the true customer demand.
And good conversations with them about the implications of this as well.
I do not believe at this point in time on the data that I've seen that General Motors will make it out of the end of the year.
And so your conclusion is by the end of this year, by the end of this month, we could lose General Motors as a corporation.
I believe that we could lose General Motors by the end of this month.
Thank you. We insisted legislatively that the GAO be deeply involved, not after the fact, but during. In my view, we need to act, not for the purpose of protecting a handful of companies. If that were the extent of the issue, I would let them fail. I acknowledge that those who advocate such a course on the assumption that pressure from the outside will produce the desired results. My concern with such an approach is that it plays Russian roulette with the entire economy of the United States. Inaction is no solution. Inaction would only add more uncertainty and instability to our economy.
Could you tell the American people today that the auto...
At our last hearing, I asked whether this was the end or was it just the beginning. We now have an answer, I believe. In just 2 short weeks, the price tag has jumped from $24 billion to $34 billion. I'm interested to hear what changed and why we should believe that things will get better as our economy continues to contract.
What have you done for me lately?
The homeless! The hungry! There's no reason to sell out!